This is the Media Funhouse on the road at Honest Ed's, located at 581 Bloor Street in Toronto, Ontario. Now, what is Honest Ed's? It's many things. It's a local department store. It's also what my mother used to refer to affectionately as a junk store. And it's a museum of 20th century theatrical history. This may seem a little odd combination, but it is truly that. Excuse the camera work, by the way, folks. I shot this on the sly, not knowing if the people who work at the store, the management, etc., would be okay with me shooting this material, but I had to document this for the show. I was in love with this store the first time I saw it. Yes, there are also little signs that prove that the owner was not only a major, major fan and a mover and shaker in theater up in Toronto, but he also was an aspiring Borscht Belt comedian. He had little jokes put on the walls of his store. This store is set to close in December of 2016, and I just had to document this stuff because I was mesmerized by the contents of the store. And it will close, as I say, in 2016 because the family has finally decided they have a hell of a lot of real estate. This runs two city blocks in Bloor Street. It can be made into a shopping mall, etc. But what it is now is uncommonly charming. Yes, it's a junk store. It's a temple of schlock. It has 99-cent goods. It sells everything from clothes to food to hardware. You can buy little Canadian knickknacks, little things for tourists, etc., housewares, but it's also a mini city that has in this two-block-long local department store a beauty parlor, an immigration office, a dental office, everything but a post office, and it has countless, as you can obviously see from this footage, countless 8x10s, some of which are signed to Ed Mervish, the owner of the store, and his wife, and some of which are just things that I think he was collecting. He must have either found a trove or from his childhood in the 20s and 30s, etc., he started collecting 8x10s of theatrical figures. Here you see some musicians. There's all kinds of different people he has on the walls, most of them relating to live performance. Who was Ed Mervish? Well, he was a gentleman who died in the late 2000s. He died in 2007 at the age of 92. He was an entrepreneur in Toronto theater. What he did was take the money he made from this discount store and from some restaurants he ran, and he began importing shows and had them go through Toronto when they were going to Broadway or to London's West End or coming from Broadway or London's West End. So he had all the shows that were coming and going from the two major cities of theater, and he made Toronto a mecca, a little metropolis for theater in his theater, the Royal Alexandra, which he bought in 1962, and the Princess of Wales, which he had constructed in 1993. So he was actually doing these things. He at one time for 18 years owned the Old Vic, or excuse me, 16 years, from 1982 to 1998, he owned the Old Vic in London. So he was definitely a man whose pulse, whose life blood was involved with theater. He also was, yes, as I say, he loved comedians and Jewish humor, etc., and that comes through in the signs and the people he's put up there. There are occasional misspellings, I should say. Of course, he has Piaf spelled with two F's. Mae West is spelled M-A-Y. But this guy loved theater. Abe. Need I say anything? That is young Abe Vigoda. Do excuse the camera work, as I say. I was a little jumpy when I was doing this, trying to get all the shots of all the different amazing things on the walls that I wanted to document and show to you folks. I should note that a few things are missing from the first time I came in the store. There are no more Elvis busts. These are photos of the great, late great Honest Ed Mervish, who honestly did make himself into quite a character. There are his TV commercials on YouTube. You can check those out. And he made himself a cartoon character. He knew what to do to sell his low-cost products in his wonderful store. Yes, since I first went there at the end of 2011, I noticed they're not selling Elvis Presley busts anymore. They used to have an area devoted entirely to music boxes, large furniture, large statues, things that presumably were outside the theaters that he ran in Toronto, all this amazing theatrical ephemera. That's been closed off. That area sort of closed off with an artificial wall. They also sell paintings in Honest Ed's. They deal in anything that could be bought in bulk and sold at cheap prices. So you will have his theatrical ephemera next to paintings, next to tchotchkes, next to things that you would put on a shelf, next to things you'd put on your desk at work, next to things you'd give as gag gifts. It is the ultimate dollar store in certain ways. And in other ways, there's in the basement all the stuff you'd really use. As I say, hardware at low-cost prices. Electrical, you could buy CD players, all kinds of things. Outmoded media, of course, is at Honest Ed. It definitely adheres to what Gene Shepherd used to call the world of slob art. He was talking about Felix the cat clocks, that whole world of knickknacks and odd-looking things, and he declared it to be a particularly American phenomenon. Well, no, this is North America. This is Toronto, of course. This is Canada. And here we get to the Jesus ephemera. Now, I've covered this before on the show. On this past year's Easter episode, I read from the Catholic coloring books that Honest Ed has. You see a variety of Jesuses and the Virgin Mary here. You have our lovely hand model showing you the lenticulars. I showed these on the program, but they're not 3D. I used to refer to them as 3D, but they're basically lenticulars. I'm particularly fond of the fact that the price tags are put right in the center of the lenticular, thereby screwing it up. But they are these genteel objects. They are drawings, paintings, lovely drawings of our Lord and Savior, the Lamb of God, that don't quite match each other. There's also some worship of the popes, the many popes. There is Pope John Paul II. There are recent popes, earlier popes, etc. Anything that relates to the popes, you can find all kinds of things in Honest Ed's roaming the aisles. This is obviously what I was doing with my camera, was trying to get as many images that just were blowing my mind as I went through this store, because it is set to close in 2016, at December of 2016. Yes, here you will notice the preponderance of quotes. He put quote marks around everything to kind of using it for emphasis, but of course that means you're not really sure when you use quotes for things like that. But yes, you can find, and I joke about it, I kid about it, I use the phrase slob art via Gene Shepherd, who I worship, but actually what this store is, as I say, is a museum. I'm brought in mind of the amazing phrase from Mark Bem's thriller novel, Eye of the Beholder. I've been very, very tied to this phrase over the years. Time passes, nothing remains except old photos of young faces. And definitely these walls, this is the underside of the stairs, if we're synced up here properly. I'm showing you the underside of the stairs. There are 8x10s everywhere. He actually made poster-sized duplications of some of the ones that he was most proud of the biggest stars, of the Sinatras and the major figures. He had major figures in British theater, obviously. All the big names in British theater would come through Toronto on their way to New York or their way from. He has local people, of course, Rich Little, Robert Goulet, all of the Canadian celebrities who we know of in America. You have, as I said, household items, maybe not particularly for your household, but you have to love the names of some of these things and some of the objects that are being sold at the store. There is something that goes on as you do the store, as you make the rounds through. This boggled my mind, I swear. Some of the stuff, even as I'm watching it now to try to provide a narration for it, it did boggle the mind. There's also a feeling of hallucination and sort of a high that you get in a store that turns into a headache. I explained it this way in my blog post about Honest Ed's, which you can find at mediafunhouse.blogspot.com. I was in the store for something like 90 minutes and experienced a range of emotions from amusement to sadness for a long-gone era to something like a headache, giving way to a giddy, slightly high feeling, helped in no small part by a scary moose head clock and some mega-trippy 3D, I was calling lenticulars 3D, wall hangings that depicted, among other things, a Manhattan skyline composed of pink and baby blue skyscrapers. Here you see Ed in the Funhouse. Yes, there are Funhouse mirrors in the middle of a local department store. It's amazing stuff. One of my purchases was a wholly needed Funhouse reading matter, the Stations of the Cross coloring book. That's one I bought years earlier. This is when you're starting to exit the store. We get to the hardcore stuff, the poster size pictures. Patrick McNee, Liberace, two of the three Rat Pack members. I don't know why Sammy is missing from this gathering. I said here also, what struck me on the most basic level about the store was how fascinating it was to see the original business upon which a small empire had been built. The pick to the right, most families that carve out a lucrative and prestigious niche would have closed down or sold off the gaudy, tacky, and yes, very useful store that provided the dough for their expansion into classier realms. You see here more signed photos. A very interesting gathering of Honest Ed Mirvish, Tony Bennett, and Peter O'Toole. I don't know why they were all in the same city at the same time. You have, of course, Liberace. Once again, there's Jimmy Durante in the corner. We just passed by Ed Sullivan meeting Ed Mirvish, the meeting of two great Eds. And this is as you're leaving the store, they're selling pressure cookers. Now, I couldn't see the autograph on the Lauren Bacall. There's no autograph clearly indicated there. I think it's hidden. And then you have Gloria Swanson. You have this amazing image of Gloria Swanson signed. She was obviously doing theater at some point. Now, I have to say, as I said before, that his theatrical empire lasted. They are still doing productions in Toronto through Mirvish Productions. You can look up their website, but they started in the 60s. What happened with Honest Ed was he really began doing it hardcore, going from fan to actual theatrical exporter-importer in the 60s, from the 60s through the 90s. So this store Shore is a history of North American and British theater from the 60s through the 90s. Now here we've exited the store and we've gone out, and I saved the best for the last, which is the way the store looks on the outside. It is, yeah, the word tacky does come to mind. By the way, around the corner, around the one corner, there is the amazing The Kims of Toronto, Ontario, Suspect Video, which sadly may have to move when Ed's closes at the end of 2016. Now, of course, we have here not only these incredible signs that are worthy of a Las Vegas or Atlantic City Wild West casino, you have these notes, these little things along the side, and you have some more jokes. You have lots of jokes, because obviously he did. There is a, I didn't show the photograph of Henny Youngman, but he did obviously love Borscht Belt comedians, and here is Ed indulging. He had these things written up with lots and lots of quote marks. So I'm very proud to have documented this. I'm glad to have shared it with Funhouse viewers and anyone on the internet who might see this. Honest Ed's is a paradise. You can still go to it through December of 2016. When it is gone, it will truly be missed, not only by Toronto denizens and citizens, but myself, people who come looking for a good deal and some really crazy artifacts of popular culture.